Mother's Day to everyone out there. Today, Carolyn Wallace is not with us. She's recovering from surgery, so we want to thank Susan Haddox, who is providing us with the wonderful organ music and playing the piano for us today. A few other announcements. The Christian Outreach Committee have baby bottles out for the month of May. Please help fill these bottles for the Alliance Pregnancy Center. And when they say fill the bottles, they mean bring some change. They don't mean a gallon of milk or anything like that. So there's a calendar of events going on in our church. Underneath that in your bulletin. So if you have committee meetings or anything like that, you'll find them listed there. The family of Brianna Starkey would like to invite all of our church friends and family to her graduation party this next Saturday, May 20th, at Christ United Methodist Church in the Fellowship Hall right downstairs. It's from noon until 3 p.m. And we'd like to take just half a second to thank Carolyn Wallace, because this is a Sunday service that is very much focused in music, and a lot of the service, even though she can't be with us, was designed and by her. And so we appreciate all of her efforts to make our musical Sunday service just that much more special. Are there any other announcements?
Outreach committee meeting and outreach committee meeting just asked, since we had previously asked you for donations to finish the high school that we are building in Harrisburg, Liberia, to give you an update on how you are doing on from that request. As a reminder of what that's about, is that Patty and I serve have made several trips to Harrisburg, Liberia with Farmer to Farmer. Farmer to Farmer is an outreach of the East Ohio Conference missions. And Farmer to Farmer recognized a need for higher education, as in high school education. In Harrisburg, there are elementary schools, and once you get to eighth or ninth grade, that's it. The nearest school then is like a three-hour walk. And so that's 6 hours consumed just walking back and forth to school, plus the time spent in school means that the family loses the child for the entire day, plus the cost of sending them to school, because they don't have public school in the sense that we do. And so most families can't afford to send them or lose their labor for an entire day. So what happens is those children hit eighth or ninth grade, they finish school and get jobs. Well, there are no jobs, but they start working to generate some kind of income for the family and start having kids before most of our kids are out of high school. Farmer to Farmer decided that Harrisburg needed a high school. So we have built a high school. It is almost ready for use. And what separates it from being used this fall is a few final finishing touches on a couple of classrooms. But mostly it is buying books for the library and computers for the library and lab equipment for the science lab and those kind of things. And so that's what we are trying to raise money for before September, so that the national Liberian government, whatever, that certifies that they can have high school students at the high school can come and do that. So far, Christ Church has raised $750. I am told that there are several people who have promised gifts beyond that have not yet come. So this is your big chance. We have flyers in the lounge. If you're interested, you can follow the directions on the flyer. But I would really like it if you would just label it on one of your church offerings and put it in the offering plate, so we can send one big check and I can brag about it to the other people on the, I can brag about you to the other people on a Farmer to Farmer board. But so far, $750, and that's what we're trying to do, is finish the library and equip the science lab and have high school students this fall. So thank you very much for your generosity, and thank you also for the generosity you have not yet expressed.
Oh, Lord, it is so.
Sandy, let's do the call to worship. Bless, O God, our peoples. Let the sound of his praise be heard, who has kept us among the living and has not let our feet slip.
For you, O God, have kept us.
People ride over our heads. We went through fire and water, yet you have brought us out to a spacious place. If I had cherished iniquity in my heart, the Lord would not have listened. But truly God has listened. He has given heed to the words of my prayer. Join with me in the opening prayer. Let us pray together. Almighty God, as we bask in the joy of the resurrection, inhabit and accept the praises and music we share today, and remind us that we will ultimately be part of the heavenly throng, singing hallelujah, hallelujah, in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
almost sound believable. Oh, how can we pray for one another? I did not get any blue cards. The usher said there were not any. Is there anything, any of you for whom we can pray or people that we should lift up in prayer?
Traveling to Israel tomorrow.
Thank you. Susan's hand. Friday. Okay. I had you on my list, but Susan's surgery is on Friday, so please. Yes. And Elijah has an MRI on Wednesday. He has a lump in his arm, so we'll find out what that is. And I did not say at the beginning, but happy Mother's Day to everyone. And a part of that prayer for Mother's Day is that we remember that although many of us have fond relationships and fond memories of our mothers, that doesn't hold true for everybody. And so part of our prayer, it lifts up all of us. Okay? So listen for that. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we give thanks for all the ways that you bless us, for all the ways that you walk with us, the gifts that you've given to us, the family that you've with whom you have surrounded us, mothers and fathers and brothers and sisters and church family and folks who mothered us that weren't our mothers, and on and on. You, that was you. You blessed us. You nurtured us. You walked with us and raised us to be functioning adults, most of us. you showed us what it was like through the example of others to be adults, to be Christians. We give thanks. We pray today. We rejoice for our mothers, but we pray for them. But we also pray for those who have lost their mothers, for those who have lost a child, those who desperately want to be mothers but can't. We pray for those who don't know their mothers because of adoption or other circumstances. We pray for those who have strained relationships with their mothers, those who have complicated relationships with their mothers. We pray for single mothers who do it all on their own. We pray for those who have decided not to be mothers. We pray for mothers who would do anything for their children. We pray for those who have mothered a whole pack of children and loved them as their own, even though none of them were their own. We give thanks for all of those people who invested themselves in our life. We pray for all of them. We pray you would pour out grace and mercy and love and hope and courage and all the things they need to get through the day. And we lift up June Luca, who is our person of the week. We pray for MRIs this week and travel this week for my whole class and for many others. We pray for Susan's surgery this week. We pray for all of those on our prayer list. We pray that you would be with and among all of them, that you would surround them with your love and with your grace and pour out healing and hope and courage upon them. Surround them with brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ who can love them, who can hold them, touch them, and allow them to see Jesus with skin on, to feel Jesus' touch by their presence. We pray you would be with all of them, walk with them on their journey. And we pray, Lord, that you would be with each one of us as we go through our week. We pray that you would walk with us, remind us who we are and whose we are. Allow us to be ambassadors of your kingdom to the people around us so that even in the nail salon or the hairstylist or at work by the copy machine or wherever people may find us, they could meet Jesus. They could encounter your kingdom and feel your love. Help us to be those people. We pray you would walk with us. And we give thanks for all your gifts, O Lord, for your Son Jesus and for this prayer that he taught to his disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power, and glory forever.
Thank you.
Heavenly Father, we give thanks to you for all the gifts that you have given to us. We brought gifts in return because we want to show you our thanks. But our prayer is that through these gifts, through your people, we would bring light into dark places, bring hope to the hopeless, and the love of Jesus to the people around us. And all God's people said,
amen.
was really one of the things that I had in mind when I inspired the writer of Psalms 150. That he wrote, praise the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in his mighty heavens.
Praise him for his mighty acts. Praise him according to his excellent greatness. Praise him with the sound of trumpet. Praise him with the psalter and the harp. Praise him with tambourine and dance. Praise him with stringed instruments and organs. Praise him upon the loud cymbals. Praise him upon the high-sounding cymbals. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Why do we have a music ministry in our church? What does it do for us? It gives each singer, bell ringer, and instrumentalist an opportunity to serve. We come together with the common goal of learning music for our services. It gives us an opportunity to develop talents, and we know what Jesus said about investing in talents. There is much to learn about each piece, notes, rhythm, how the parts fit together, what the composer intended for the musical performance, and in bell ringing, how to physically play all of one's assigned bells. It offers the opportunity for fellowship. It is one more way to praise God, just like the Psalms command. Music reaches parts of the brain that nothing else will. Even dementia and Alzheimer's patients can be brought to life when they hear a familiar hymn. It imparts God's message through another sense. Musical presentation of the word is often more easily remembered by some people. It helps keep the heritage alive. The musical heritage of Christ United Methodist is one of longevity. Organists and choir directors have had long tenures in our church. One of the current choir members is serving their 50th year in the music program.
Psalm 98 says, "Oh, sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. Shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. Burst into jubilant song with music. Make music to the Lord with harp, with the harp and the sound of singing, with trumpets and the ram's horn. Shout for joy before the Lord, the King."
Thank you.
Please remain seated to enjoy the postlude after we're done.
We're going to let the choir sing you out. I won't be here next week, as you know, but have a great 2 weeks, everybody.